Alright, so you want to make amazing, fun and good-looking traditional levels in Mega Man Maker, but you don't know what to do or how to do it? Let's fix that! Hey everybody, my name is Tim and in this video I will show you exactly how I made this level and some useful tips and tricks for you to make any level you want without people disliking them. Alright, so let's start with the basics. Before building anything, you are going to need a level idea or level type. It can be an electric theme, or a water stage, or both. There, I just got a good level idea to base my level, Watery Watts. I'll talk about how to design the level space in just a second, but now I will showcase a useful trick that sadly not many people use. The Rumba Thingies, also known as the palette of the level, which is probably a much better name for it. The palette is a dedicated screen in the Mega Man Maker level builder where you are going to add every tile set, enemy, gimmick or boss that will be on your level. Let's start by making a tile set. Yeah, I'm pretty bad at this. Using multiple tile sets at once is not required by any means, but it just looks better most of the time. You can also be more creative with it, allowing for so much more customization. A good idea is to experiment with the tile set on the first screen of your level, as I did here. This is the tile set I chose for my level. Yes, I agree there are a lot of different tile sets here, but it makes the level so much better. It will look pretty bland without them. This is the same level, you know? Enemies, another important part of a level. I mean, you can always throw them in there, but what even is this? Every enemy should have a set reason to exist in a level. For example, this enemy is placed here just to scare the player to go to the left. And this one is guarding these goodies. And then there's this one. What are you doing? Of course, we need to follow the theme of the level. Mine is water and watts, electricity. So every enemy in this level is going to be electricity based, kind of at least. We also need to choose the number of types of enemies that will be on a level. I put 5 enemy types in this level, which is the recommended amount. You don't want to just put every enemy you can find. I chose the Elegant, the Classic Mets in there and Knowing Self, Joe McJoson Classic, the Electric Gavion, and this guy. Oh, and a fence. I also picked the mini boss of this level, which is a fish for some reason. Anyway, last thing you should add to the palette is 1 or 2 gimmicks, the amount of checkpoints, and the background. Use only 1 or 2 gimmicks if possible. You don't want to bug the player with all sorts of different and random gimmicks. You should also choose a fitting song for the level. We are done with our room of thingies, now it's time to actually build. Before placing any tiles, some pro level builders start the level design by placing the backgrounds in the correct place, that way allowing to have something to follow when placing the level design. You can also place dummy tiles in those rooms to be able to change the screen transitions to wherever you want them to be ahead of time. And please don't ever do this. This is called screen wobble and is so annoying in levels. It's normally pretty easy to fix though. Yeah, also don't make levels like this. Thank you. Now it's time to start designing the level. Always remember to not put enemies in unfair positions and never put more than 3 or so enemies in each screen. When introducing gimmicks, make sure to make it safely and try not to make your level too hard or too easy. Think about it this way. If it's too hard for you, imagine how it would be if you tried it for the first time, you know? And this is how my level looks when it's finished. It goes on with a decently easy start, and as the player traverses through the stage, it will start to get a bit harder. After the first checkpoint, the spikes are introduced to the level, making the jumps harder. And just before the boss room, I added one last challenge of the level, which is way easier than it looks. And yeah, what is this boss? Well, I tried not to make the boss generic by adding a bit of randomness to it, because let's all be honest here, Sparkman is boring to fight and way too easy. I think that's all. If this video was useful in any way, shape or form, consider throwing lemons at the like and subscribe button for more Mega Man Maker. And if you know somebody that makes not so good levels, remember that sharing a video is possible. You know, let's stop this. Yeah. The ID for Watery Watts is down in the description field if you want to play it. And if you have any more useful tips for Mega Man Maker level building, feel free to leave them down below in the comments, as well as any level IDs you guys may have for a possible second video. And that's my level, how I made it, and how you can make an even better one. Happy building, everybody! My name is Tim from Game Hero 9. I hope to see you next time!